Hello everyone, welcome to the final part of The Empire Strikes Back in LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. I am Jango Fett. Hey look, is it weird that when I think of Fett, I think of Jango before I think of Boba? Look, I was 9 in 2002, what do you want from me? Since we recorded the last episode, I did go and pick up the times 6 score multiplier. It's now on, so I have 48 times score, which is going to make score a joke. If it wasn't already a joke before, it is a joke now. But let's finish up this chapter in the Star Wars saga. Once upon a time, there was a young boy named Luke Skywalker, and he sat somewhere. I can't keep this bit up because this voice is very silly. I sound like Lane in Mad Men. He kind of talks like this, but he talks more like this. I've been watching a lot of Mad Men recently, and well, by the time this comes out, I would have finished it and been able to like watch the whole like the series will be done. But at the time recording this, series isn't out yet. Like the series finale isn't out yet, and I haven't caught up. And I want to catch up for them so I can be there on the final day. Nothing as it seems. Oh, they tell this from both perspectives. I would have done this one first. Hey, it's Lando. Goodbye, 3PO. I found 3PO really annoying in this movie. Like, it is the beginning of Star Wars' most famous trait these days, bad comedy bits. And 3PO in this movie is the start of that. Like, it's got the most dramatic, tense final. That's good. Final sequence, and 3PO will just be making bad jokes the whole way through it. And it's fine. It's a goofy, fun thing, but it's like every 10 seconds they will cut to 3PO for a joke. And I'm like, I got it. We're good on this. One of the more subtle but still excellent arcs in this movie is that of Lando. I want a Lando movie. I want a Lando prequel. That's what I want. Do you see that? You see how I got one and then it went True Jedi immediately? He should be dead. Oh. I can't get up there, can I? No. Can't go that way. Okay, what do I do? Da-na-na-na-na. Right, I turn it back to stairs. Cool. Look at how rich I am. It's bounty hunters over there. What's that? That will be RTD2, I assume. Yeah. But Lando's arc is great because he sells them out, and it is all done through like a little bit of dialogue every so often. But he's got the lines about how he's only doing this because he is like responsible and now like wants to care for Cloud City. So he sells out his old friend in order to protect his city, and he thinks he's doing the right thing, and that's how he justifies it to himself, which honestly is a much more interesting bit of characterization than anything in that Han does, because Han has his whole thing is like, you know, hey, I want to get out and I'm selfish, but really I got a heart of gold, and that's Han in a nutshell. But like, the conflict in this movie is just I want to go but I can't, and then Leia likes me, and then I like accept my sacrifice at the end. He doesn't have anything as interesting as, like, he never betrays them and then walks it back, whereas Lando does. Lando is introduced to betraying them and becomes a hero by the end of the movie, and he's, like, a minor character. He's, like, being able to do that with a small character and make it work is a sign of really good writing. And it's super thankless, too, because really good nuanced writing, and by nuanced I mean, like, functional but not overbearing in a, like, action blockbuster way is easy to just miss. For example, there's a film released in, like, 2002, I think it was, called Jet Li's The One, which has this sequence where, like, there's two Jet Li's, because they're both fighting to be the one Jet Li. Aw, bye. But yeah, it has the sequence where there's two Jet Lis, and you suddenly realise that you've switched perspectives between them, and now you believe the other one is the true one, and, like, it is in this really poorly reviewed, ridiculous, cheesy action movie from the early 2000s. But because it has, like, that kind of writing, it holds a really special place in my heart. I think it's that kind of stuff is incredibly valuable and should be called out more when done well, because it's really hard to do well. It's hard to write anything. Shit, can't go that way. Oh, I've got R2 now. Damn it. We go. I love the music in this. John Williams brings it. Is that is that like a battle droid? Oh, hey, look who it is. Can you not? Oh, I need to push that in the plug socket, don't I? It's weird to me to think that it's now implied that battle droids exist in the same universe at the beginning thing. Honestly, it's weird that clones do, because there aren't any anymore. Like, no one in the original trilogy, the Stormtroopers aren't clones. I hope that's not part of the retcon, at least. I'm fairly sure it's not. I remember playing a game where they explained that at some point the Empire realized it was easier to recruit people out of fear than to actually clone them. There we go, we're back. Which I thought was a cool touch. By the way, there's still two more score upgrades coming, so we're going to be so rolling in it that it'll be ridiculous. But you need to for some of the final upgrades. I don't know, I'm not going to go for 100% of this game, but I might do. I'm probably going to play a little bit after I stop playing. It's a fun game. I enjoy it. Like I say, I'll see if that's streaming it once this is done. Whee! Everyone get some hats on. Everyone, wear them. What do you mean Leia can't be a Stormtrooper? Right, Lando is. Made it, come on. Yes. I always worry about losing the stormtrooper hat. Now I don't need to. Now I'm invincible for a while. It's through here. Come on. Oh, that's one of my favorite musical cues in Star Wars. Right, who's left? Oh, it's the droids. You could have hovered. Come on. Oh, but I need to get them up. Oh, there's a lift. Okay. I was like, do I need to bring them, put them up there? Nope, there's a lift. Come through, everybody. There we go. We've got to bring 3PO with us. How are we going to get him over here, I don't know. Maybe Chewie could carry him? I hope there were arguments like that in this game, when there were like design problems, but in the film there were actual narrative problems and they solved them a certain way. He'll be like, well, maybe Chewie could just carry him. In my head, I imagine every collaborative effort as like a world of passive aggressivism. That's probably bad. It says something bad about me. I don't know what though. Walk free, C-3PO. Walk free. Do it. Do it. Make it happen. Bam. 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 Lando don't stop for nothing. Look at him go. Come on, R2. Beat the gas. What's that? It's a gas mask. Why? Because of the gas. If you don't know where that quote's from, then it's okay. Don't worry about it. You're good. Link them up. Let's go. Let's get out of here. I'm enjoying this level a lot. A bunch of the levels in this game, especially in this original trilogy, have been like too long and too repetitive. But this has been a great closing level. Actually, maybe I'll talk about that sometime in Return of the Jedi when we're closing our thoughts on the game as well as the movies. Like, what makes a good LEGO Star Wars level? Because I don't know. I haven't really thought about it. They're all like, they're all this kind of low impact thing. Like, how would I define a good Lego Star Wars level? You know, like, each bit wouldn't last too long. Each bit would be like fairly simple. It would have a lot of variety of little puzzly elements. Maybe as I go, as I end this, I will try to think about what my favourite levels from the game are. Because I've been talking more about the movies than the game. That's been by design. Anytime you want to stop shooting them. Oh, I just had to fight to that part, okay. Man, there were long, protracted arguments about which level to put first, this one or Luke's one. There must have been. Like, because you would have ended the cutscene there. And then you'd have put this part of the cutscene on to the end of Luke's cutscene. It's a good shot. Good one. They made it. Episode 5 complete. One more episode to go. We'll be back soon. Yeah! Lando Calrissian. Princess Leia's hair is good on Bespin. Get me paid. Look at it. Look at that cash. Why did I get extra money for getting 661? Alright. Let's finish the story and let's go home. There's not really any wrap-up in Empire Strikes Back. I mean, there's just this one shot. And they do plan the beginning of Jedi. I forgot that they do that. Like, he says to Lando, we're meeting on Tatooine. We're meeting on Tatooine. We're going to get him back. We're going to save him. But this shot is so good. The implication that they're, like, outside the galaxy, because that's what it looks like. They're not really, but they're looking on everything. They're looking upon everything. Everything in front of them. Everything's going to be okay. Because Empire doesn't have a depressing ending. Like, I truly believe that. I know people say it does. It really doesn't. It has this calm shit. What's going on? We've got to be. It has this really centered ending, and it's like the most chaotic things have just happened, and everything's changed. But they're looking out to the future, and they're gonna do this, and it's really good. I don't know. Empire Strikes Back is not good because of the ways in which it's dark. It's good because of the ways in which it's not dark. Right. We'll play those credits in full next time because they're long. I don't want to play them 5 times in a row. Let's run through here. Run around. Kit Fisto, say hi to Kit Fisto, Lando. Kit and Lando. That's my new sitcom. Why am I still here? I'm gonna go away. See you next time as we begin Return of the Jedi and make it into the home stretch of LEGO Star Wars The Complete Saga. Goodbye, everyone, and good night.